Hello friends, once again welcome to Tech with Us. Friends, in this series so far we had discussed waterfall and V model for software development and also talked about their strength and weaknesses. For more detail about this series, you can check out the link provided in the description of this video. Now let's move one more step further and try to understand spiral model. This model is highly recommended for long-term, complex and the project with high risk. So in this video, let's explore spiral model in detail and try to understand its various phases, its strength and weaknesses. So let's start. Let's see few highlights first, which we can build upon our understanding in the coming slides. Spiral model is a risk-driven software development model. Means it is most suitable for complex, long-term and high-risk projects. Here by risk I mean in software development there could be many risk factors like new technology, research, maybe clear requirements are not available, critical timelines where product need to be released in market as soon as possible. So all these situations can impact product timeline and need to be considered as risk during development. So one thing is clear here, we cannot use waterfall or V model in such scenarios, which will restrict us to stay in a development phase until its preceding phase is completed. Here more suitable approach could be incremental approach, which evolves over time and provide flexibility to correct and to improve. Which takes us to our next point. Spiral is an incremental model. The underlying concept of incremental model is first implement a partial or base software and then keep reviewing and releasing new functionalities added on top of the last release software. So in summary, model like Spiral, which follows incremental approach, are based on divide and conquer philosophy and provides two powerful tools. The first is requirement prioritization. Customer or team can decide which requirement can cause potential risks and can prioritize them accordingly. Such one approach could be develop high risk and major functions first. And the other is it provides good feedback mechanism. Means individual releases can be tested with its limited functions and could be improved in later releases. Friends, there is no doubt that Spiral model is a great model, but there are few downsides also. It requires good planning, expertise and excellent communication mechanism. So if anything goes wrong, the flag can be raised immediately to reduce the risk of cost and time overrun. And of course, maintaining a spiral model is a costly affair. Great, so now let's look into the various phases of a spiral model. So here we go. Don't get worried by looking at this complex diagram. I will slowly try to explain each phase in detail. The phases are similar what we had already seen in waterfall and V model. A spiral model has four phases shown by the four quadrant in this diagram. So means at any given point of time, the project will be in one of the quadrant. Then you can see the circles, which are the iterations of a spiral model. Each iteration ends with a potential software release. One interesting thing in this diagram is its third dimension, which contains the prototype. The prototype is nothing but the scaled down version of the final product. Now let's discuss the various phases of a spiral model and what activities are performed in those phases. In a spiral model, an iteration starts with a phase called determining the object of the iteration. This phase consists of various preliminary activities like defining the problem, gathering requirements and identifying the success criteria of this iteration. This phase is dedicated for planning of the particular iteration, and there could be multiple decisions are taken by the team, like identifying the alternatives and constraints. After this, we will move to the next phase, which is identifying and resolving the risks. As we already know, Spiral model is a risk-driven model. There is a dedicated phase to identify and resolve risks. In this phase, all stakeholders review and validate the objectives, alternatives, and constraints planned during the first phase and try to resolve the potential risks. Then we have development and test phase, which is also called as engineering phase. In this phase of the iteration, the actual development and testing of the software takes place. The next phase is dedicated to plan the next iteration. This particular phase is the mix of reviewing the previous phase and planning for the next phase. So in this quadrant, team and customer sits together and evaluate the development so far and also start planning for the next iteration. Great friends, after understanding this much, we got to know that there are quite a few strengths of Spiral model. Here is the list for some of them. You can take a screenshot for your future reference. Along with the strength, there are some weaknesses also, which we need to consider. Spiral model emphasizes good amount of time in evaluating risk. So obviously, it is not suitable for small and low risk projects. Apart from this, there are few other weaknesses also, which are presented in this slide. So here we come to end of this video. Please share your feedback on this video in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe my channel techvedas.learn for all future updates. Thanks for watching. Hope you like it.